Round two is set to kick off now. And on one side, we have sassy Stacey Howard. The other side, we have Rachel the Crusher Cushing. And it goes down now on JTH Reacts to the Movie Trivia Schmodown. You think she's ready to crush? I know she is. Let's not waste any more time. Let's do this in 3, 2, 1. Well, well.
What do we have here?
A little bit too early.
Well. Hello, outlaw.
Don't give me that hello, outlaw crap. You've been ducking me for far too long, Riley.
Here's to a good match. And go, Rachel.
Dude, I'll take you on Schmodown. Any day of the week, anytime.
Any day, anytime?
Any day, anytime, Roka, just like last time.
Well, why don't you put your money where your mouth is? I owe you for that one.
I know someone is going to say,
oh, I want to Schmodown right now.
Why are you wearing a U.S. flag? They're both from America.
I want to Schmodown right now, Riley.
Well, then
I wanted to wear it. End of story.
Oh, it's getting hot in here. And if you think these two take movie trivia seriously, you
probably shouldn't have wore it because last time I wore it on a video, I lost in a wrestling trivia showdown match.
We are proud to introduce
Bummer.
The Movie Trivia Schmodown app.
Hope I don't put any bad juju on the crusher.
Fans will be able to play all trivia modes and compete against your favorite competitors, join a league, or play a friend one-on-one. After you accrue enough points, you can unlock the inner geekdom division and play in another format. Find some fans from all over the world, climb up the rankings, deem a champion, challenge a champion.
Oh, hello, Stacy.
We're so excited for y'all to finally get your chance to play the Movie Trivia Schmodown. This app is for all you movie trivia fans who have ever said,
I totally knew that.
How'd you miss that? It's for everybody. Make sure you guys download it right now on iTunes for a one-time fee of just $3.99. And make sure you request to join the Movie Trivia Facebook page. And then one day, maybe you can challenge the likes of Aroka, O'Reilly, maybe even your old pal, Baby Carrots. I'll be your Huckleberry. It's Schmodown time.
Caleb trying to do his Mark Ellis impression yesterday. All right. Come on now. Kaboom! Let's do this. I'm ready.
Ladies and gentlemen, Sassy Stacey Powers! Upbeat Arthur. She's joined. Wait a minute, she's looking at him. What? I don't know what the hell's going on over there. Oh no! She did. Oh my god, you knew that they're staying together.
Stacy has become like her partner Brienne and a winner. And what you are looking at here is the future of the Schmodown. The Mark Rileys, the John Rokas, the Dan Merles, the Mark Ellises. Those are things of the past. This is the future, and the future has a new personality.
You hear about that new TV show? I don't know what things are doing. I haven't seen
Cowboy,
it yet.
But I wrote Deep
Throat. Oh, no. No.
Oh,
finally able to really prove myself as a singles competitor and pull my weight. You know what? Here's the thing. Rachel, as a fellow female competitor, she's my friend outside the Schmodown and in it. I respect her a lot, and I feel like if I went up against her, it would be a good even, you know, even.
Nice back and forth.
Yeah, nice back and forth. So, you know, I respect her so much. If I went against her and won, it'd be amazing, but if I lost, I'd be proud of her still.
If you went against her, I would cry.
Me too.
I might literally cry on camera. Let's not have that happen, please. Go, Rachel.
I'm so sorry for you. Listen, you're right.
Also, forgive me in advance if I start hacking everywhere.
So why not
Come over to I've had this better. Really nagging cough you can excel more than for the last couple of days. The heights you've never reached. The has let the dogs out. Done
what Brianne is doing, what Stacy is doing. How about it? Just think about that. Enjoy your evening.
As far as going forward, like, I'm going to, but, you know, I've got to pick myself up.
Well, you
I've
won't
got
hear
to
any
about,
of that.
You know, the direction that I want to go in. I do want to be in the singles league. And, look, I really admire Brianne and Stacy and even Jay. Like, they're competitors, and I love what they're doing with their faction. But, like, right now, you know, I just got to focus on me and the Inner Geekdom, the singles tournament, and, you know, and I will forever be this man's friend.
Hashtag don't break up Nerds Watch. Please, please, please. Power of Crusher prevails.
Stacey's a dark horse. I mean, her opening match against Jonathan Voitko,
she said she's going to keep using the Terminator theme.
She's a friend,
I like it.
And I
yes.
think going up against
Big
her
thumbs
could be
up.
A lot of fun.
I am so happy.
Oh.
Congratulations.
Thank
we
you.
Talked about this.
Jeff, go home. Jeff,
you did,
go
wonderful.
Home.
And now you get to go on to play the winner of Stacey Howard versus Mark Ellis, who we already know is going to crush baby carrots. Then everybody wins. We all win. It's a beautiful thing. The whole family wins. Have a great time. Enjoy this. We'll talk about everything else later, okay?
That's just Jay being Jay. Look, I have not said yes to
Jay
anything.
Being Jay being
you know,
Jay
Ken
being
and
Jay.
I are still figuring our stuff out, so Jay's a sweetheart.
Yeah.
I do love those girls, but yeah, no, I have not made any decisions.
Yeah,
Pushing. Ah, power. Who you got? Her. Not her. 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 Hello, Mark.
Singles tournament.
Hello, Ken.
Matchup between Rachel Cushing and I can't say the name. Cut the camera. I can't call this match. Now, I don't want to do it.
I know Stacy defeated you, Mark.
I've been drinking for a while.
I know Stacy defeated you, but you have a lot going for you in life, all
no,
right?
No, I got nothing.
You've got a stand-up comedy career, a great baseball card collection, and that shirt and bandana. You have so many things going for you. You can pull through.
You really like the bandana?
It's pretty orange.
Versus Stacy Howard, who somehow defeated me and has made it into the tournament. Ken, you look at what we got in front of us. Boy, yep. I hope I sober up by the time the match starts because it could be a good one. Because he's
Pokemon, sure.
For the Misfits, and it's going to be interesting to see what happens with Rachel Cushing, win or lose, after this matchup.
He has been wooing her since we lost in our team match, and I lost my smile. He jumped into our interview. He's been making
you lost
no,
your smile.
No subtle.
Shawn Michaels would be impressed with your smile.
Join the Misfits. Join Miss Movies. Join Sassy Stacy Howard. Join me, and we'll complete your journey to the
lost
top.
Lost a lot of things, and one of them's been my smile.
On her own, but, you know,
and I need
nice
go back,
friends.
Find
you
out where I lost it, because I lost it somewhere.
For Jay Washington, but then you look at Stacy Howard, and Stacy Howard's somebody who I don't think I underestimated, but my God, she came in and she just beat the living shit out of me. Let's be honest, folks.
Biggest punch ever.
So far that I had to move back in with my mom in Virginia.
I mean, that's fair that you would make that decision based on just a defeat. I'm okay with that. But yeah, I think that's part of the problem. Look, nothing away from you. You're a former champion, a top-notch competitor.
Ah.
But I think
people overlooked
Stacy Howard, and they overlooked her for far too long. And she came in here, took a big uppercut, and just knocked you straight on your baby carrot's ass. And you got to give her credit.
Thank you for the soft landing, Ken. Let's go to our competitors
right
now. Right
up your baby carrot's ass.
Other in the pregame.
It's round two. Not very many people.
Hello, Rachel.
Far, so I not only crushed Andrako, I crushed a lot of brackets, and it feels good to be here.
No, you didn't.
Here
you didn't crush
are,
mine. I was
two.
Already dead.
People thought we never were going to make it. They thought Brianne wouldn't make it past Clark. and Stacy wouldn't get past baby carrots. But now, Clark Wolf has been
dismissed.
Baby carrots has been
dismissed.
I was thrown into the Schmodown just to prove that more women could play as a favor to some friends and to see what I could do. Fast forward 9 months, and look at me. I've been playing in singles. I've been playing in teams. I've been playing in Inner Geekdom, which is my whole league.
Oh, no. I got sure of that
one. It's been fun. It's a lot, but it's been fun.
Rachel, we love you. We have so much respect and adoration and adulation for you. We've extended this offer. We brought, we said, come to us. Join, you know, the hand, the mermaid thing, all that, the song. Now, we're just waiting on your response, because the fact of the matter is, here's your finals of the single tournament, right here. How glorious would it be if you come along and be right on our side?
I will admit, there's a little bit of added pressure. Not only have I been playing in so many leagues, there's a lot going on outside of it. Ken is taking a step back to feel out what he wants to do moving forward in the league, and Jay and the Misfits have been after me to join their faction. And you know, I've been thinking a lot about it, but I gotta concentrate on the game too, so there's just a lot of pressure coming from all of that.
This is where you belong, but you're gonna learn a small little lesson first, cause you're gonna lose to the sassy one. And unfortunately, just for the tournament, Rachel Cushing will be
dismissed.
No.
Sorry.
Sassy Stacy, I respect the hell out of you. You have done so much in this league, but I've done some stuff too, and I am really excited about this game. Win or lose, I've made my decision about the Misfits, but you know what? I think I'm gonna win.
That's a good plan. I like that.
Well, you hear that, Ken, and I think the big news coming out of the pregame is that Rachel Cushing confirming that she will make a decision one way or another after this match, and for no other reason, just to get Jay Washington off her back so she can just compete in this here tournament.
It's very important that you make decisions. That's what the manager of Del Taco tells me every time in the line for more than 5 minutes. He says, make that choice now. She's going to make that decision today. That is big. And, of course, you got Jay and Stacy. There's a lot of energy there in that group.
You say Del Taco. I say I'm hungry. Let's get this match on the road. It is time for the tale of the tape. Ken, tell us some strengths.
Absolutely. I know Rachel Cushing's strengths very well as the Crushers tag team partner in the Nerds Watch. I know she's got classics. She's got directors. She knows directors that I didn't even know existed on planet Earth. She knows the answers. She could also pull over into that inner geek.
Crushing things. Known for crushing things. Me known for making songs about crushing things.
Knows a lot. Rom-coms. I think Sandra Bullock movies, Julia Roberts movies, action, adventure. She surprised a lot of people by crossing over genres. And of course, if you're part of the Misfits, dance movies are in your strengths as well.
Dance movies are a staple. Yeah. Stacy Howard also very good at hating vegetables, even if they're cute, tiny babies. Ken, are you ready to do this thing?
I'm ready.
Vegetable
you ready?
Harassment.
Ready as I'm ever gonna
be. Is the audience
You're
ready?
A vegetable predator.
And it's time for the
movie trivia showdown.
A second round competition to a finish.
Ring that bell.
Introducing
ding, ding,
first.
Ding.
Representing the Misfits. With a record of 2 wins and 0 defeats, she is Sassy Stacy Howard. Well, we got this
movie.
Oh, showing off an entrance, and you're not even in the match. You're showing off an entrance, you're not even in the match.
And there is Stacy coming on out. Look at that.
They know their movies, they know their classic cinema, their Kubrick, if you will.
Milk.
And the glass of milk honoring A Clockwork Orange. Very,
very
creepy, very well done.
No,
Jay Washington keeping it classy thus far. Here we go. Who will they be competing against?
All right.
I wonder
and
who.
Her opponent, representing the Nerds Watch. With a record of 2 wins and 0 defeats, she is Rachel the Crusher Cushing!
Oh, the Cush, very, very stone face, enjoying the listen to this overture from the crowd, and they clearly are a fan of either Terminator 2 or Rachel Cushing.
Yeah, absolutely. Sunglasses. She's going to crush. She's going to crush.
There it was.
All right.
But then she blows kisses, too. It's nice to have a woman crush you, then blow you a kiss.
Absolutely, absolutely. All right, settling in here.
Losers. The dude with the receding hairline in the front and back.
Are you talking about me or Ken?
You pick your poison. Both of you all are recipients of the Hair Club for Men.
I wish. Yeah.
Nice hat, sir. Nice hat.
That is all Virginia's finest wardrobe you have on. Now, I just want to say, Rachel, we appreciate you. We support you. Okay? We hope for the best. She's going to win. But we hope for the best. Now, win or lose, we'll be there for you. Remember that. We'll be there
that.
For you. We'll be there for you more than Ken Knapsack's hair products. We'll be there more for you than the horrible shirts that Mark Ellis has.
Horrible.
We'll be there for you than that horrible bandana from a Lynyrd Skynyrd concert. We will be there for you. You will not treat me like I'm Dan Nino, okay? I have way more class than that.
Jay Washington exiting the stage. If you guys enjoy Jay Washington, make sure you check him out when he takes your order at the Cheesecake Factory. And
that's too far, Mark. Come on now.
Round one.
All right, excited.
You know better than
that. I'll see if they're ready.
The competitors are going to hear 8 questions from 8 different movie categories. Once you hear the question, please write down your best attempt at an answer. And then when we ask you to reveal your answer, please show what you wrote on the whiteboard to the camera at the same time you verbalize it into the microphone. Each question is worth 1 point. There is no penalty for missing a question, nor is there stealing available in round one. Rachel Cushing, you are the favorite in this match. Are you ready to go?
I'm ready.
Stacey Howard, I don't have much to say to you.
I'm ready for a little bit of ultraviolence.
All right, if they're ready, it's time. Let's get ready to schmodown!
Yay!
All right, kicking us off in the ultimate schmodown singles tournament quarterfinal match between Rachel Cushing and Stacey Howard. Your first question comes from the world of dramas.
Dramas?
Who played Hugo in the film Hugo?
Oh, who was that guy?
Direct question there.
Who was that clown?
I like a good Hugh. I don't have any personal friends named Hugo as far as I know. I would like to gain one.
I know a Hugh. 5, 4,
darn it.
3, 2, and 1. Pens are down. Rachel.
Asa Butterfield.
That is correct. Oh. 1 point.
Butter.
All right.
Rachel Cushing. There goes a perfect.
Guys, second question is in the category of animated. Who voiced Anger in Inside Out?
On one corner,
you ever see that movie?
There was a Starbucks.
Across
the street from that Starbucks. The exact same building as that Starbucks. There was a Starbucks. Louis Black.
Louis Black?
That is correct for a point. Rachel.
Louis Black.
That's right, 2-1 lead.
All right. 2-1, both competitors on the board as we move to family films. Aww. You will find a toy store by the name of Duncan's Toy Chest in what family holiday film?
One or two?
I'm going to call that one two. Potential deep cut.
Did
but
you
they
hear
are right.
Toys R Us went bankrupt?
Yeah.
The smell of Toys R Us as a youth is
five,
the greatest smell you'll ever have.
3, 2, 1. All right. You have Rachel up first.
Home Alone 2.
That is correct. We'll accept that. Stacey.
Family Vacation. I didn't know.
Incorrect. All right, Rachel's up to 3-1 lead.
3-1 lead for Rachel, the fourth category.
All right, fourth question. Category is rom-coms. Rom-coms. In Win a Date with Tad Hamilton, who played the girl that won the date with the hunky Tad?
I'm going to start calling you the hunky Ken, because I feel it fits.
Husky Ken is what people call me.
We've both been husky in our lives, my friend.
5, 4... 3, 2,
that bitch, Cameron
1,
Diaz.
I don't think I knew it. Kristen Bell?
That is incorrect. Rachel.
Kate Bosworth?
That's correct. Rachel's perfect
this was
so
not
far.
The bitch.
Perfect so far.
That's right. And a reminder that if you are perfect through round one, you do get a bonus question aimed only at you. We'll see if the crusher can continue as we move on to your next category, which is action adventure movies. Who played Bruce Wayne's childhood friend, Rachel Dawes, in Batman Begins? That Bruce Wayne's got some money on him.
He does. Yeah. He does. He owns a big apartment.
He probably does have a number of apartments around the
five, world. 5, 4,
got a
3, 2, and 1. All right, Rachel.
K.
Katie Holmes, Maggie Gyllenhaal did it better.
Everybody relax.
Okay.
We're sorry, Katie. She's a big fan of the show.
Editorial. Stay tuned.
Katie Holmes.
That's right. All right. Keep the pace. 5-2.
Got three right already.
Six is in the
Can I get more than three?
Comedies. Who directed the modern comedy classic Dumb and Dumber?
Oh, yes.
I agree with that assessment.
I'm going to get more than three.
Classic.
Yay, me.
That guy had in 1994.
Absolutely. Five, four.
It's the Farrelly Brothers.
Two and one. Pens down. Stacy.
The Farrelly Brothers?
That is going to be correct. Yep.
No. No, it's not. No.
How do you spell it? I spelled it F-A-R-L-E-Y. I don't know how to pronounce it. How do you spell it?
It's Farrelly. Not Farley.
All right, we...
The answer is Farrelly Brothers. Mm-hmm. And the Farley Brothers, I don't know that we can...
I'm going to say that...
I'm going to leave the ruling to you.
You're a gentleman. I'm going to say it's an incorrect answer, which will probably beget a challenge. All right, Jay Washington's going to challenge the ruling.
But hold on, though. Wait. But now she knows how to pronounce.
I wrote it down.
Rachel did write it down.
Yeah.
Just for safety's sake, let's see Rachel's.
Farrelly Brothers.
Okay. Okay.
I didn't spell right.
So we do have a challenge on the table from Jay Washington. Yes. We'll huddle over here.
They can't give her that. She didn't say it right or spell it right.
So we have conferred with the judges up here, and we cannot award the point, Ken, for the reason it was not only spelled incorrectly, which we can forgive, but it was also pronounced Farley.
Chadwick Boseman.
Farrelly Brothers, and it's a really tough one, but there is precedent in here, so we cannot give the point to Stacey Howard.
It's tough ruling.
Fair enough.
And after all that, yay! I got more than three.
For anything in this regard.
That's
fair enough.
Rachel Cushing did have the correct answer written down, so it was Farrelly Brothers. Were the director
brothers.
And Rachel
right.
Cushing continues her first round
6-2. I have a 6-2.
So it is 6-2, and now we move on to fantasy sci-fi questions. What Jean-Claude Van Damme sci-fi action film revolves around two soldiers killed in Vietnam that were revived to life as cyborgs?
I'm going to guess you count this as a modern classic.
This question should be worth 10
I wouldn't know that.
They're both riding there. Stacy's got to recover from this challenge here.
That's a tough challenge.
And we're
going to
say
really
5, 4, 3,
Universal Soldier.
2, and 1. Rachel.
Universal Soldier.
That's correct.
That is correct.
Stacy Howard.
As a double team.
I mean,
it's not
bad.
Far
guess.
Off
I think that's
from
like a Disney film
team.
About twins.
Not that far off from the plot of Double Team. Dennis Rodman. We salute you.
Now, as we go to this final question, of course, Mark, Rachel is possibly looking at a perfect round. If she
one
gets
question
perfect,
away.
She get the bonus here. Mm-hmm. It is 7-2. Question 8 is in the category of Oscars.
Ooh.
Meryl Streep received her first Academy Award nomination for what film? All right, a lot of pressure here.
Yeah.
Big moment, potentially turning point.
Meryl who? Yeah. What's that actress's last name?
Not
I'll
sure.
Keep
not
my
sure.
Eye
Five,
on her.
Four.
Seems to have
Iron
three,
Lady.
2, 1. And Stacy.
This isn't right. Sophie's Choice.
That is incorrect. Rachel.
The Deer Hunter?
That is correct.
That is correct.
First 8. All right. This means she gets
five
a
out
bonus
of eight.
Question just for her. Doesn't have to
write
it down. Just has to answer within the time limit.
And your bonus question that is to Rachel and only Rachel for 1 point. The term Twitterpated is the word that is described falling in love in what Disney
101 Dalmatians.
Bambi.
We talked about
Perfect.
The Deer Hunter, and then we went Bambi.
Well,
you see what we did?
That's
we did the Deer Hunter, then we shot Bambi's mom in the
you did that on
Twitterpated indeed, Ken.
All right, we're going to move on around.
Because it was all
a commanding 9-2 lead, but a good wheel round, and Stacy can pull back in here, and you never know.
On a side note, wow.
Broken by that wheel.
You're looking at a guy who Stacy
this
had
got
a great
ugly
wheel
really
round
quickly.
Against. She is one of the most fierce competitors in this tournament. I have no doubt that she can bounce back.
I'm at 5 out of 9.
Very, very tough challenge.
Damn good for me.
What an amazing round for Rachel. We've seen a lot of the perfect rounds, first rounds before. She's the first female competitor to get all 9 questions right. So great job, Rachel, there.
That's right. I believe the first competitor to wear sunglasses through the whole first round. Right. We get them all right as well. All right, round two, also known as the wheel round. Each competitor gets a spin at the wheel positioned yonder. Each category on the wheel corresponds to four questions up here at our answer desk. Each question is worth 2 points. If you're not sure of the answer, you can check to multiple choice, at which point the value of the question will go down to one. Keep in mind, competitors, there is stealing available in round two. However, there is still no penalty for missing a question. And if you don't like the category, spin it first, you are allowed a mulligan. Just in case, Rachel Cushing, you are in a commanding lead. Would you like to spin first or defer to Stacey Howard?
I'm going first.
Right. The crusher is just looking to rack up points.
Strong, girl.
Usually what we do.
Good spin, good spin.
That Nerds Watch competitions there. We like to go first to put pressure on people.
Much better spin than Jay Washington could have ever given it, and it is drama.
Drama.
I'm keeping it.
She's going to keep drama, Ken. It's going to keep drama. I will be asking Rachel.
Taking drama, and this might not have any drama.
And we go to the world of dramas. Your first question. In JFK, who plays the mysterious military figure referred to only as X?
Thinking it over.
Kevin Bacon?
That is incorrect. Stacey Howard for a 2-point steal.
Well, I'm going to ask something. It's not right. Kevin Costner?
That is also incorrect. We're looking for Donald Sutherland.
You got to guess.
No.
Throw it out there.
Recipient of an honorary.
Heard Donald Sutherland on a worldwide movie trivia.
Good play.
All right, your next question. Rachel. Who played Lorne Lutch, the original Marlboro man, in Thank You for Smoking?
Multiple choice.
Is it A, Russell Crowe, B, Sam Elliott, C, Jeff Bridges?
Sounds like Jeff Bridges. Yoakam?
Sam Elliott.
1 point for Rachel Cushing. 10-2.
JTH.
Your next question in the world of dramas. What is the name of the tiger in the film Life of Pi?
Richard Parker.
2 points.
Richard Parker.
Rachel Cushing, odd name for a tiger, but a great answer by
Richard
Stacey,
Parker, he's
by,
named
by
after
Rachel
the
Cushing,
guy from Weekend at Bernie's.
Last question.
Richard Parker.
Bruce Willis's wife in the 1999 film The Story of Us.
Michelle Pfeiffer.
Two points.
Ha. All right, that does put a little pressure on Stacey. She's technically in KO territory right now. You got to assume she's going to get some right, but I've seen Stranger Things happen. We have to point that out going in.
All right, go ahead and give that wheel a spin, Stacey. Oh, man, a lot of gusto in that spin. Better spin than I would have done in this match. Looking for
opponent's choice.
And the bad luck for Stacey Howard just continues, Ken.
Give me your
So now, Rachel Cushing, hearing some suggestions from the crowd.
But Mark, this is interesting. Rachel could go for the kill.
She doesn't have a weakness. That's the problem.
I mean, she could go for the kill there, Mark.
We're at 14-2.
I mean, go
Ridley Scott.
And Jay Washington have worked something out.
That's right.
You have to wonder.
That's right.
I asked for this category. I want Ridley Scott.
All
good.
Right. Ridley Scott.
Ridley Scott.
So we see Rachel taking a category that she knows is a strength for hers because she can't really find a flaw in Stacey Howard's game. But Stacey Howard will get first crack at this slate of four Ridley Scott questions.
All right. Four questions, Stacey. First one coming in. What year saw the release of the war drama G.I. Jane?
I want to say it's 96. But I don't know for sure.
All right. He's not called for multiple choice yet, so 5, 4, 3.
Multiple choice.
All right. A, 1993. B, 1996. C, 1997. D, 1999.
I don't think it was as late as 97 or 99. I don't think it was as early as 93. I'm going with my original choice, 96.
That is incorrect, Rachel.
97.
That is correct.
No.
That's right. 15-2.
I was close.
Very close.
All right.
Hit me with the next one.
Second question. She's confident.
Never
second
give
question.
Up. Never
who
surrender.
The character of Galaxy Dallas, Quest, 1997. Captain of the ship in 1979's Alien.
Hmm.
Brianne's going to be mad at me that I don't know this one. Multiple choice.
Multiple choice. A, Harry Dean Stanton, rest in peace. B, Tom Skerritt. C, John Hurt. D, Bill Paxton.
Tom Skerritt?
That's correct for a point.
Yeah. Tom Skerritt getting some love.
All right. She needs these ones here. All right, third question. Who played the Lord of Darkness in the 1985 film Legend?
I have no idea. Multiple choice.
All right. A, Tim Curry. B, James Earl Jones. C, Frank Langella. D, Peter Weller. Five, four.
Peter Weller.
That's incorrect. Rachel for the steal and a possible win.
This could be the game.
I'm sorry, but it's Tim Curry.
And your winner, by way of knockout.
It was hard to watch, but it was still good to see Rachel win.
Cushing, 16-3.
Ouch.
Dominant performance, Mark. Dominant performance.
A hell of a performance by Rachel, Ken, but I got to give it to my former playing competitor, Stacy. Yeah. I had some drinks to kick the show off, but I will tell you this. She is as good as we have in this league right now, and she got dealt the worst set of cards I've ever seen a competitor in a playoff format get. Not only did she have a very tough challenge go against her in round one, her opponent got an extra question, and then she spun opponent's choice in round two. I mean, what's anybody to do in that scenario?
You know what? And she
have me accompany
like
them?
A champion.
That'd have been worse.
Superstar. She stared down the challenge and she tried to overcome. She just didn't this time. But I believe Stacey Howard's star is still rising in this league. And talking about stars rising, Rachel the Crusher Cushing moves on in the Ultimate Schmodown Singles Tournament. Big
That's
win.
Right. So Rachel will play the winner of John Rocha and Sam Levine. And once again, Stacey Howard, hats off to you. If you need any advice on how to cope with losing, let's throw it over. Jen Sturger, who's
me
both
too.
The winner and the
I know
loser
a lot about it
right now.
What's up, Movie Trivia Showdown fans? I'm Jen Sturger here with someone who has definitely earned the name Crusher today. Rachel, that was a phenomenal match.
Thank you so much. I am really riding an adrenaline high right now. I mean, I love Stacey, but, you know, to have round one, the last two matches, round ones have finally gone in my favor.
Again.
It's been my nemesis in the Movie Trivia Showdown. And I just feel good that I'm able to get to the answers now and that I'm rolling good categories. Like, this is an adrenaline rush. That's the best way to describe it.
And look, there wasn't an answer you didn't know today. That's so crazy. Like I said, there are great performances. There are good performances. And then there are just, that was a next level performance. And I think you've got to even be feeling it yourself. Like, I might be one of the better champions in the upcoming champions in this league.
I'm getting to the point where I actually think I might believe that. I'm getting more confidence with each win. That's where I'm going. And like I said, I've had problems pulling answers in the past, and like this confidence boost is going to make that easier. And like, I think I can go toe to toe with the big guys now.
Do you think a lot of it has to do with comfort? Like, are you just getting more comfortable behind the desk and under the lights?
It's definitely part of it. I mean, the lights and the cameras are still new to me and they still scare me to some extent, but I'm able to harness the nervousness better than I ever have in the past. And, you know, and I got some luck. I mean, I did, but you know, it feels good to know the answers and to get them right in the match.
And so look, you went up against Stacey today and it definitely did not go her way at all. But can we talk for a second about the Misfits and the offer that Mr. Washington has made you?
Yeah. Hi, Jay.
Hi, Rachel. Excuse me, Jen. Listen, congratulations.
Thank you, sweetie.
That was phenomenal.
Good job, B.
You did something the ranks that only certain people could do, and I'm happy for you. It hurts really bad. Got eyelashes on. It hurts. You shut your mouth. It hurts that you won like that, but you won. Congratulations. I'm proud of you. But let's get to serious business. We just want to say, how about you just make the decision, come go higher, let's just run this whole thing together.
I can't tell you how thankful I am for the invitation that you guys have given me. I've been thinking about it a ton.
But you should.
But here's the thing. Like, this is about Ken and I, and he is off to find his smile, and
he
I love
here.
That man. He's not, but he will come back. I truly believe that he will.
That man
the
is
Nerds
to get
watch is not done. It's he's got to do what he's got to do, Jay, and I got to do what I got to do. And you know what? I'm waiting for Ken to come back and for the Nerds Watch to come back. I love you guys, I do, but you know, I'm going to have to turn down the Misfits.
You can make yourself useful. Hold that. You did what? The answer is no. The best thing you could have did is join us. Now you're going to wait on the old dude who got AARP around the corner. You're going to wait on Ken Knapsack and his hair plugs. Okay, I see you want to make mistakes with your life and your career. You got to win. Congratulations. I hope you get your ass smoked like fireworks in the 4th of July next round. Have a good evening. You go, you're dismissed. This whole thing is over.
I'm so sorry about that, Jen. Here.
Oh, my God. Yeah. Definitely took my microphone. This hat's dumb. But congratulations.
Anyway.
That was an awesome match. Sorry for the interruption. That was rude.
Rude?
I guess. You know, he put on a nice
Wait,
face
what is
for
this,
a while.
Full house?
And
How
I guess
rude?
I should have expected that.
No.
But I got to do what I got to do. And, you know,
that
hats off to that whole
Yeah, I'm Charles Barkley.
To Stacey. You know, the luck didn't go her way, but they're going their way, and I'm going my way. And that's to the semifinals.
Sorry, Mark. Ken, they don't want to give another interview. I'm pretty sure Jay said everything he needed to say anyway, so I guess we'll just send it back to the desk.
Okay. I'm making sure they're not listening. I did want to say one thing, though. Okay. So, this is a women's tournament, as I said. I, as Stacey Howard, not the competitor, am glad that my friend, my real-life friend Rachel, is going on. So, you know what? I'm here for her. I'm making signs. I'm cheering on the sidelines. I'm really proud that she is moving on and that she's going to kick everyone's ass. She's going to win the whole damn thing. Okay?
Stacey!
Ah, sorry! Okay.
Traitor!
Where'd she get that microphone from? It's weird. Back to you guys at the desk.
All right, well, there you see it. I mean, Rachel Cushing pretty much par for the course when she talks about getting a W and looking forward to her next match, either Levine or Rocha. Ken, do you see her being able to take down one of those competitors better than the other one?
You know, Sam's on a hot streak. Rocha is a former champion. I think they're evenly matched against Rachel. I think at this point she's just going to have to prepare for either one. There's not a matchup I see that works better than the other.
That's right. And Stacey Howard handling her loss with class, as we would expect her to do. One of the bright, shining stars in the league right now. I think that she's going to make a lot of noise coming up sooner rather than later.
You're absolutely right, Mark. And you guys, don't forget, if you're not a member yet of the Movie Trivia Schmodown page on Facebook, request to be added
thing.
And get Aaron inside Turner. All the fun conversation. And don't forget to listen to the Schmodown Rundown on the Schmoes Know Podcast Network there, Mark. Frank, Aaron, Brian do a great job.
I've heard of that podcast
that
network.
Is the first time I've actually plugged
listener.
My
that
name.
Ken Knapsack. I am Mark Ellis. Thank you guys for tuning in.
That was sudden.
This is Frank from the Rundown, and we just witnessed.
She only got one question wrong. I've already
Rachel
done your job for you.
KO
You're dismissed.
Score of 16-3, and all kinds of history and records were made today. Now there isn't much to get into match-wise.
There's not much to get into.
To a 9-2 lead, and in that process became the third player in singles play to earn a perfect round while answering the bonus as well. And after that first round, Stacey was never able to get back in the game as she
was thanked
after her third question in the second round. As you can see, she answered just 3 out of 13, was not able to convert on that
steal opportunity.
So now that 3 points is tied for the lowest point total here in the Collider era, which matches Ashley Robinson's point total when she faced off against Mike Kalinowski. But the real story here is Rachel.
Yeah,
Cushing.
I already did
she
that job for
14
you.
14 out of 15 questions, capitalized both times on her steal opportunities, putting up 16 big points with a point differential of 13. That's the largest point differential in Schmodown history. And following this performance, Rachel Cushing has become the only player in Schmodown history to have back-to-back matches where she has missed just one question. In two
I
matches,
did job for you. You're dismissed.
Out of 29 questions. The only comparable performance you can look at is when Dan Merle was in the triple threat and then faced off against Sam Levine, where he missed 3 questions in the span of those 2 matches. When you're being compared to Dan Merle, you're doing something right. Now, as we move on, this is just going to be one big, long Rachel Cushing record update. Starting off, let's start off with the consecutive questions answered. She now has the longest streak with 22 questions answered in a row. She answered 13 in a row against Andreiko in her last match, and then she combined that with the 9 questions she got here in the first round.
Where did it stop?
And she is now ahead of William Bibiani's previous high streak of 21 questions.
Bibbiani. Oh, but he's overrated. But he's a bust.
An answer streak of 20 questions or more. But she now reigns supreme over players like Dan Merle, Sam Levine, John Rocha, and Drew McQueen. And when you take a look at where this performance stacks up all time throughout the entire history of the Schmodown, it ranks number 5, just ahead of McQueenie, and Rachel's own performance against Andrako, ahead of Tim Franco, Clark Wolf, and John Rocha when he faced off against Christian Harloff in last year's singles tournament.
Still cool to see speaking of Tim on there. Tournament,
this performance is now the second best performance in the singles tournament. Again, outdoing her own performance over Andrako and Rocha, she has now solidified herself as a true force in the tournament. And now the records do not stop there. When we talk about people who have started 3-0, we talk about people like
JTE started out 3-0. It's hard to believe.
They were the only
and then what happened?
To start 3-0. Rachel Cushing now becomes that sixth player. And in doing so, through those three matches, she now has the highest score percentage. And when you carry that over into what that means for three-game winning streaks, that means she is also number one. There's only been 10 other streaks by 9 other players, Mark Riley being the only player to have 2 three-game winning streaks in the history of the league. But Rachel Cushing, as of right now, holds that top spot for the
And I jumped on the bandwagon first.
Yes, even better than the dangerous Dan Merle. Now, there are a slew of other records Rachel has
Well, we ain't got time for that because they don't give me enough time.
That info, I'm not just Rachel, but also other teams.
Plus, I gotta have stuff to talk about on my show.
Twitter. And if you want to listen to a full breakdown of this match, as well as every other match, be sure to check out the Schmodown Rundown podcast every Saturday on the SK Plus YouTube channel, as well as on the Schmoes Know podcast feed for iTunes. That's gonna do it here. I'm Frank Janish, and this has been your post-match Schmodown Breakdown.
It's well, the Schmodown after game.
Well, hello, Outlaw.
Don't give me that hello, Outlaw crap. You've been ducking me for far too long, Riley.
Oh, ducking you? Hardly, dude. I'll take you on Schmodown any day of the week, anytime.
Any day, anytime?
Any day, anytime, Rocha, just like last time.
Well, why don't you put your money where your mouth is? I owe you for that one.
Oh, yeah, you want a schmodown?
Oh, I want a schmodown right now.
Oh, you want a schmodown right
I
now?
I want a schmodown right now, Riley.
Well, then draw.
Oh, it's getting hot in here. And if you think these two take movie trivia seriously, you should take the fans into consideration. Y'all have been begging for your shot at the movie trivia schmodown. And now you get your opportunity. We are proud to introduce the Movie Trivia Schmodown app.
How are they playing when their fingers aren't moving? I just realized that. You all ain't playing. Competitors join a league one-on-one.
After you accrue enough points, you can unlock the inner geekdom division and play in another format. Find some fans from all over the world. Climb up the rankings. Deem a champion. Challenge a champion.
Oh, Stacy.
Make sure you've earned it.
We're so strong today.
So excited for y'all to finally get your chance to play the Movie Trivia Schmodown. This app is for all you movie trivia fans who have ever said,
I totally knew that. How'd you miss that?
It's for everybody. Make sure you guys download it right now on iTunes for a one-time fee of just $3.99. And make sure you request to join the Movie Trivia Facebook page. And then one day, maybe you can challenge the likes of a Rocha, a Riley, maybe
or
even your
me.
Old pal, Baby Carrots. I'll be your Huckleberry. It's Schmodown
Huckleberry.
Time.
Well, 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 that was very, very not pretty. Rachel, wow, that was awesome. That was great, phenomenal, glorious, incredible, insanity. So Rachel moves on, stunning, convincing fashion, first to advance to the semifinals. She will take on either the winner of John Rocha versus Sam Levine, and Yikes. That's going to be a huge, huge, huge match. But that's going to be for a little while. Going to be interesting to see everybody else that comes out in the second round. The next match, ironically, wearing the red, white, and blue, the next match is the Patriots Civil War, as they have coined it, the Jeff Snyder JTE match. Going to be that's going to be interesting, and as I said in my last reaction, it's going to be kind of awkward to react to, knowing everything that's happened. But still can't wait to see it. Going to enjoy it like a Schmodown fan should. It's going to be great, entertaining, needless to say. So with that being said, that is going to do it for this edition of JTH Reacts to the Movie Trivia Schmodown. Like, comment, share, subscribe to their page. Always watch their videos first. It's the right thing to do. Follow me on Twitter at WWEJTH1. Join Joe Morton's Fan Reaction League. Join the Wrestling Trivia Showdown. There will be trivia, movie battleground, worldwide movie trivia, everything pertaining to the Schmodown. Join it, because everything that they produce is awesome, and everything that everybody that does that contributes to the Schmodown is awesome. But we'll find out next time what happens and everything in the Schmodown. So until then, this is JTH saying until next time, thank you for watching, and I bid you adieu.